Hello and welcome to this review of the Onyx Boox Max 3. It is an Android tablet that has an e-ink screen. The difference between an e-ink screen and a normal screen is that an e-ink screen is reflective. It only uses the light from natural sources and it has no backlight. The good thing about this is that you can take it out into the sun and view it just as fine and as in a darkened room. But if there's total darkness, you cannot see anything. Another drawback is that it is only in black and white, and it doesn't have that many shades of black, white and gray. There are also other disadvantages, but I guess since you have searched for this review, you probably know a lot of them, but I will take it up as it comes. One special thing about this tablet, and it is a tablet normally when something has an e-ink screen, I would just say then it's an e-book reader that can be used for reading e-books and perhaps playing music, but this is a real Android tablet. That means you can run any app you can run on Android 9, but one of the disadvantages is that you have to let it boot every time you want to use it, unless it has to use the same amount of power as any normal Android tablet. Usually when you have an e-book reader, you can just put it down and then the picture can stay for weeks or years without any problem. This tablet will switch off at some point. But let's look at the performance. This tablet has the very special feature that it has an HDMI input connector, which means you can use it as a computer monitor. And I have tried to attach it to a Windows computer. And if it looks a bit odd, then it's because the resolution of this tablet is very high, a bit higher than full HD, which means as I have enabled the feature on Windows where it tries to scale everything up. That's also why I've chosen to use Word, because I know it probably supports this scaling feature really well, where other programs may not do it. So if you see any problems, it shouldn't be due to the program I use. I will try to let the mouse come into the screen, and as you can see, it's a bit choppy. Actually, there's a lot of lag and it's very difficult to show the lag with a mouse, but I can try to do that by typing. I will type some text you can hopefully hear when I hit the keyboard and then see what the lag is. As you can see, there is quite a lag when you type. If you adjust, my feeling is that if you're just writing some text, that's no problem, because you know what you are writing and you can use the 10-finger system, it's not that big of a deal. But if I'm going to correct some text, then it's just a bigger problem. I will just try to change something. As you can see, because there is some lag, you don't have the feedback right away. So sometimes you have to stop just to see where the cursor is, and there's not really anything you can do about that. Actually, you can do a little bit, because if you press the screen, then you can choose between text mode, speed mode, and X mode. What you just saw there was the screen refreshing. You can set it to how often you want it to refresh, and the refreshing will get rid of ghosting on the screen, and I will come back to that in a bit. But if you choose text mode, then the screen will become highly optimized for just viewing text, and you can see especially here up in the ribbon that it doesn't show the usual detail, but the text has more contrast. If you choose speed mode, which was what we used before, then you have a lot more detail and it's also faster. But as we will see later, the text is not quite as good in certain ways. And X mode, yeah, it doesn't look that quite as nice, but that's even faster. I will just try to demonstrate. It's not that fast actually, but there is still some lag. But in each mode you can also adjust the contrast, which I think it will shape text in different ways. As you can see now, when I increase the contrast, the places where there should be a white paper, they can actually become darker, which of course depends a lot on the contrast algorithm. So there are some ways to change how the image is presented. I think we should say that now we take a look at ghosting. I've copied several pages of lorem ipsum text to the screen. You can see it here. I will just press clear. This will clear the screen, so there's no ghosting from my changing the contrast. I will just try to scroll up and down a bit. Give it a lot of use. This you can say this simulates that you are editing a lot of text. And this will show to a certain extent how bad can ghosting be. I will try to get it really ghosted. And people who you are used to old e-readers would know by now an old e-reader would be completely unreadable. And then you can actually see it's not that bad. I will just try to press the refresh button. So look at this. There was a little bit of ghosting, but it wasn't that bad. If we try the same in X mode, that's made for quick updates, but lesser quality. You can say you don't want to read text in this, but it's actually made for web browsing and viewing videos. And yes, you can view videos and see something. Yeah, it's not that bad in the end. I think the most you see from this ghosting is actually just from the mode, and should just try in text mode. Get a lot of text. Yeah, you can clearly see there is some ghosting, but and ghosting also depends on what has been ghosted, because if you are a programmer, then there's often more text to the left, and then there are a few long lines, and they might annoy a little bit more, but I wouldn't say that's so bad. When I use this monitor, I will compare it to an early 90s LCD monitor on a portable computer. That's what we call laptops now. It would crush your lap by then. You just saw it refreshed. But there was, at that point I can remember, there was a lot of lag and not as much ghosting, but there was something like ghosting. People could work with them. I have this is a 13-inch tablet. I have written a lot of code on a 14-inch screen and also on a 13-inch screen. In a moment I will try to zoom down and zoom into the text, and then you can see why I'm not programming on it right now, at least, or some of the reasons. This is the closest I can get the camera to zoom, and you might be able to see why text is not that good for me on this computer. That you can see the text is very rugged. Some letters are very big. Some of the lines and some letters, you can see this T for example, or compared to this T. There's a lot of difference in those letters. So some are very thin and almost unreadable, some are thick. And I actually think it's not the tablet's fault. if I look at the same image on a nice LCD screen that this computer puts out from its HDMI port, it's also a little bit fuzzy. It's a Lenovo X250 and a docking station. That's a laptop that's 3 or 4 years old. So I actually think this computer don't give a very good HDMI signal, but I have not been able to find a computer, at least in what I have, that gives a good HDMI signal. That's both on LCD screens and on this tablet. I will just try to select speed mode. I actually think if I should read some text off a monitor, then I would prefer to do it in speed mode, which was why I started there. You might be able to see it that the text looks a bit better. There isn't this big difference between the thick and the thin letters. But instead, there is a lot of fuzz around many of the letters. So instead of a straight black line, what should be black is very dark gray. Actually, that's most of the time okay. But around the letter, there often is this halo of light gray, so you have to make the text bigger than necessary in order to use it, and it's not that great. I will just show the same text in X mode. Be sure to clear it. It's not that much better. So I would say if you should try to use this tablet as a monitor, you should look very closely when you attach an external monitor to your computer and see, does this produce a very good HDMI signal? Because if it produces a bad HDMI signal as this computer, then I wouldn't use it. I would also say that the refresh rate is perfectly okay when you are writing something, but if you are switching between many windows, and especially if you try to position your mouse. Actually, it's very difficult to see here. But if you can imagine, from you press a button, until you can see what happens, it takes perhaps half a second, a little bit less perhaps. It's not instantaneous as usual. Then it takes a long time to get your cursor to the text you want to edit. So for programming and debugging, no, it's not that great, because even if you get everything set up so you can use keyboard shortcuts for everything, it's not that easy. I can show a good picture in one way. Because this is an Android tablet, I can actually install a Citrix client. I have done that on it. And log into my work computer using Citrix to show a good image from this. Unfortunately, I cannot connect directly to the computer using the Citrix client, but I think I can demonstrate what I want to demonstrate using just the search bar of the login page. So I have written the word this. You can see there still is some lag, and I will actually try to demonstrate the mouse cursor. The tablet has the feature that depending on which app you show you are using, it will try to optimize the parameters of the screen. And the parameters are, for example, how often does it make a complete refresh, how fast is it, compared to quality. And as you can see here, they actually can... No, you cannot see it on the cursor. But when I'm using the cursor, it's actually quite okay. It starts moving almost right away, and you can see it most of the time. So in this mode, it's actually quite usable. As you can see, when it comes to the text, there's a little bit more lag. But the quality of the letters are absolutely perfect, I would say. So to sum it up, you have only black and white. There is some lag, and it depends a lot on what you are doing, how you can set up each app. The quality of the screen depends a lot on which HDMI output your computer is able to give, or if you can use something like Citrix. What you cannot see right now is that actually I can try to zoom out on it right here. I have connected my keyboard and my mouse using a USB hub and an USB on the go connector. You can get some angled connectors that will fit much better than this was just what I had. But then if you have to fit a complete keyboard, you cannot take this out. But the tablet supports a Bluetooth keyboard. I don't have one, so I cannot test it. But if you have a Bluetooth keyboard and Bluetooth mouse, I would say it could be quite okay to take outside and sit and write on it. It has a touchscreen, but the touchscreen is not very reactive. I can see if I can demonstrate. I cannot, because when you enable a USB on the go or attach a USB mouse to the tablet, it will disable touch. But I can say, when you cannot press twice fast, it's not at all like writing on a phone or tablet. I wouldn't use this for anything but short searches and entering passwords. But all in all, if you have the right input, the tablet is actually, it is possible to use the tablet to do some work, but it's also pretty expensive. And if it's up to, for my sake, I would say I might sell this and wait 5 more years to have the technology become a little bit more mature. I can also see I have to set up a lot of programs to really come around the shortcomings of the tablets, such as the low refresh rate. I've also read that if you use a dark background in your text editors, which many programmers does, then ghosting is worse, so it's better to use a white background, and that's okay when you have a reflective surface. I bought this because I hoped I could put it in front of the screen on my normal laptop, then go outside and sit in the sun and be able to do some work. That will be very inefficient, but I would be able to do it. I wouldn't make any conclusions, but I'm probably not going to work on this one. So this is a review in a real situation using a real computer that's not optimal at all. But then I can say I have paid for the tablet myself. I have no affiliation with anybody, and I hope you can use the review. Please comment and ask questions.